Now, from South Seminole Academy in Castleberry, Florida, direct from the third floor of building number 3, this is South Seminole News.
Good morning, Hurricanes. Happy Monday. I'm Alisa.
And I'm Taylor. It's February 22nd, 2021. Welcome to South Seminole News. At this time, please stand for the pledge.
Let's check on Bristol for a daily report. Good morning, Bristol.
Good morning, guys. Today's weather is cloudy with a chance of rain in the forecast. It's cool out with a high of 81 degrees. A reminder, if you take any photos of yourself this school year, send them to us at southseminolenews@yahoo.com so that we can put them on the news. Now let's take you to the South Seminole Lounge for the lunch report. Good morning.
Good morning, everyone. Today's lunch special is a 100% all beef burger or black bean burger with french fries. All meals include fruit, vegetables, milk, or juice. And now in the lunchroom, Red Apple Dining will offer the new spicy chicken sandwich.
A reminder that you have two indoor options for lunch this year. You may sit in the cafeteria or leadership hall. Once you've made your selection, you must stay in that location.
Here's today's Black History Month trivia question. Who was the first African American to appear on the U.S. postage stamp? Was it A, Martin Luther King Jr., B, Jackie Robertson, C, Harriet Tubman, or D, Booker T. Washington? We'll answer that right after the commercial break.
That's all for today's report. If you or your class would like to record anything here in the South Seminole Lounge for the Friday show, please contact the newsroom. We'll see you next time. Now back to you in the studio.
Thanks. You'll find more news from the South Seminole Lounge every week on the Friday afternoon show.
Be on the lookout for a different segment every day of the week. The Dean's Den on the Friday afternoon show with Mr. Fernandez and Ms. Pearson. Mindset Monday with Dr. Coleman. Hurricane Smiles on Tuesday with Ms. Arshafi.
Win-Win Wednesday with Ms. Reed. Mertz MVP on Thursday and Fabulous Friday with Ms. Mafus.
And now we take you to Mindset Monday with Dr. Coleman.
Hurricanes, and welcome to Mindset Monday with Dr. C. And today, I just got to finish recording my welcome message for our incoming sixth graders for our hurricane experience that was held on February 9th. So I said, okay, I have my fancy pearls on. I'm ready. I'm going to go ahead and record for our kids here. So welcome again to Mindset Monday. And this portion of our Mindset Monday, which goes under Mindset 1, Everything is Possible, today we're talking about embracing creativity. And you see, I have my notebook. I just want you guys always to know that I utilize my planner. You guys should too. Okay, so when we embrace creativity, the only time you are creating new things in your life is when you are being imaginative and innovative. If you want things to change and you want things you have never had, you must do things that you've never done. You know, sometimes, you know, think about that hamster that's always going around and around and around and around and around, around on the little wheel. They're not going anywhere, but they're running anyway. So, you know, if you want something to be different, don't always do what you've always done because it's always going to be the same. Step out. Step out, be imaginative, be innovative. Okay, and this could be in other aspects. Another example could be reading a book, acquiring new knowledge, debating a topic with a friend, or undertaking a new activity like skydiving. And on a side note, Ms. Mafuz wants us to go skydiving with her. Your principal is not about to go skydiving. But, you know, I'll go and cheer her on if that's what she wants to do. Your life can only expand through creative action. So that's what I challenge you guys to do today, to be creative, to step outside your box, be innovative. Who knew that we would be in a pandemic right now? So we're all doing so many different things. Who knew I would have to record a welcome message for incoming sixth graders when we thought the pandemic would be done last year. So we have to keep being creative, keep being innovative, and that is going to be the key to our continued success. This is Dr. Coleman, and you know I'm always keeping it real. Have a great day, and remember, if not you, then who? Bye, guys.
Thanks, Dr. Coleman. You can find her segment and all of her videos on youtube.com/Seminole News.
A message from Ms. Kylie about cheerleading tryouts.
Ms. Kylie can be found in room 39. You need to collect a tryout form from her before tryouts begin.
Official tryouts start tomorrow from 4:15 to 5:30 in Leadership Hall. Please see here before tryouts begin.
A message from the Beta Club. Any students that would like to wear a hat on Fridays may do so for the price of $1.
With your $1, you will receive a wristband to wear your hat.
Please visit any of the three classrooms below on the screen to turn in your dollar.
This will take place every Friday until the end of February. Thank you from the South Seminole Beta Club.
Attention teachers and students, the 2021 volleyball season is almost over. Congratulations to all the teams that played last week. The final tournament will be on Saturday, February 27th.
We will broadcast the volleyball games live on our YouTube page at youtube.com/South Seminole News beginning around 4 p.m. on Wednesdays.
Like and subscribe to our YouTube page so that you can get an alert when the live feed starts.
A message from the SSA yearbook staff. You can still pre-order your yearbook at www.johnstons.com for the price of $40.
Also, if you take any good photos, send them to ssayearbook@yahoo.com. If the yearbook staff likes your photos, they may end up in the book.
Take photos all school year and send them your best ones. Good luck, school photographers.
We're going to take a quick commercial break. When we come back, we'll tell you about our Black History Month spotlight.
Once again, here is today's Black History Month trivia question. Who was the first African American to appear on a U.S. postage stamp? Was it A, Martin Luther King Jr., B, Jackie Robinson, C, Harriet Tubman, or D, Booker T. Washington? We'll answer that right after the commercial break.
We'll be right back after this.
Welcome to SciHigh. We're a school full of individuality, principles, and talents that keep the world running. We are learning to be future ready and use design thinking and innovative techniques.
Design thinking is a creative process of steps that emphasizes collaboration among partners. Our students and even teachers use design thinking to give solutions to real-world problems, from nationwide problems like creating a new way for students to learn, working with global companies to create a smart mirror, countrywide problems like designing a more efficient school bus, or even problems as little as those right here at Seminole High School, like creating a self-watering garden at main campus so the culinary kids can learn from farm to table.
Thank you for coming on the tour with us, and hopefully we'll see you next year at SciHigh.
Welcome back. Here's today's Black History Month trivia question. Who was the first African American to appear on a U.S. postage stamp? Was it A, Martin Luther King Jr., B, Jackie Robinson, C, Harriet Tubman, or D, Booker T. Washington? The answer is D, Booker T. Washington in 1940.
Today we continue with more spotlights of different people for Black History Month here on South Seminole News.
Up next, we'll continue with Booker T. Washington.
A man who was born into slavery and ended up giving advice to American presidents? Stay tuned for more with my top five fun facts about Booker T. Washington. Booker T. Washington was an American educator, author, and advisor to presidents of the United States. Starting off with fact number one, Booker T. Washington was determined to learn. As a child, he had to work and go to school, walking miles back and forth to school after work, finally learning to read and write. With fact number two, Booker T. Washington continued his education at Hampton Institute, where he learned skills to work and ended up becoming an instructor at Hampton Institute, too. Moving on to fact number three, Washington was a good teacher. In 1881, he took over Tuskegee Institute, spending much of his life working on the school that he began with all African-American students, learning skills in farming, agriculture, construction, and sewing, and eventually turning it into a university. With fact number four, Washington is known in history as a great speaker. In fact, on September 18, 1895, he was invited to speak in front of a mixed crowd in what came to be known as the Atlanta Compromise, which was one of his most well-known speeches and also one of his most hated speeches. With fact number 5, Booker T. Washington did the unthinkable, sitting down at a time where African Americans weren't treated as equals, but with a president. That's right. Booker T. Washington sat down for dinner with President Theodore Roosevelt, where he arrived at the White House to give advice, and it ended up turning from giving advice to sitting down with the president for dinner.
Look for more Black History Month spotlights all month.
Also, South Seminole Academy will host the 2021 Black History Month Talent Show.
Students will submit videos to Ms. Arby at the email address down below.
The talent show forms can be picked up in Ms. Ekavoy's classroom, room 10.
Also, Ms. Puentes in room 210, Barber in room 308, Ms. Arby room 240, and also in the cafeteria.
And there will be a Black History Art Gallery during lunches in the cafeteria and leadership hall. If you would like to submit your work, please visit room 231.
On February 26th, it will be Dress in Your African Attire Day. On that day, please take photos and submit them to satsumnews@yahoo.com.
A reminder to parents and students that you may vote on the Teacher of the Month by clicking on this QR code here on the screen.
You can pause this video or go to our YouTube page to scan this image.
A reminder for all students that signed up, Read to Lead will be after school every Tuesday and Thursday until 5:30 p.m. in room 235.
Any students that would still like to sign up, please go to room 235 and ask to be put on the list.
Attention all girls basketball players. Tryouts will begin today after school.
You must sign up to try out. Scan this QR code to get the sign-up form to try out for the team. Please continue to follow South Seminole News for all updates.
See Coach Downey in room 331 with any questions. Once again, scan this QR code to get the sign-up form to try out for the team.
That's all for today. Make sure to check us out on Instagram and YouTube at South Seminole News, and don't forget to subscribe.
Also, please like the South Seminole Academy and PTSA Facebook pages for more info.
And students, every day here at South Seminole Academy, we strive for success, take responsibility, opt to lead, respect others, and make good choices.
Thanks for watching. I'm Taylor.
And I'm Elisa. Have a great Monday, Anne.
Don't forget to storm.